Greetings, fellow Earthlings. Welcome back to some more of the Scrolls Arena. We are in the town of Evermore. It's 8:19 in the morning and it's really foggy. Today's task at hand is to look for clues to the next location, which I believe, if I'm not wrong, was Black Marsh. So without further ado, I suppose, let's go get it. So, Black Marsh, as the name sounds, Murkwood, right? So, basically, as the name sounds, it belongs to Black Marsh, because Black Marsh is supposed to be like, marshy, as the name does suggest. So, and Murkwood sort of fits that description, but then again, I mean, the woods of Morrowind could be, there's also a volcano here, and knowing this game, I'm guessing that the next piece of stuff of the staff of chaos should be somewhere within this volcano in Dagoth-Ur, I suppose. So, I guess we'll just go ahead and check Black Marsh first. So, where do we want to go? And I wonder if we can see any Argonians here, like actual Argonians, like those lizardmen crawling around here. Let's go to Hellstrom. 69 days, nice. Wow, that is a fast moving horse. Meter 16th of Earthfire in the year 3390. It took 69 days to reach your goal. Nice. You enter the city gates of Hellstrom, noticing the dark looks of the guards. Noticing the dark looks the guards give you. They have a reputation of being very dangerous. Perhaps you can change that. What? I'm sorry, I didn't mean to do that. Yay, these guys look grey. And this actually looks amazing. Red sky, and that seems to be a mountain in the distance, a sunset over there, and some woods. Let's go back inside though. I mean, yeah, these guys are grey, but they're not exactly Argonians. So, oh well. Sorry, I meant to ask you a few questions. Where is Murkwood? Last I heard, the Mage's Guild was looking for somewhere near Stormhold, or was it Hellstrom? I'm not sure, but you should probably start your search around there. Oh, Stormhold or Hellstrom? Where are we right now? Aren't we in Hellstrom? Yeah. And where's Stormhold? I'm just checking for a second. Stormhold. Not too far. I guess we'll just go ahead and check the Mage's Guild on this one. The Mage's Guild. It's southwest of here. Thank you very much. Ah, here it is. And that is actually quite a nice looking temple right there. I guess they still hadn't made up the lore about the hiss and stuff like that at this point. You enter the Mage's Guild, a world where nature holds little power. Outside, leaves are falling and plants are dying back into the ground. But in here, strange flora lives year-round, competing for space next to the scrolls, potions, and other mystic apparatus that crowds the guild's shelves. Nope, it's not this one. So Stormhold should be it. Let's go to Stormhold, and it's already nightfall. Anyway, moving on. I mean, it's twilight, not nightfall, so not like the book or the movie, but yeah, the natural phenomena. And it's nighttime, I have to take rest for some reason. But okay, it took 5 days to reach a goal. Stormhold lies on the northern tip of the province of Black Marsh. Here the people seem friendly, but a strange shows in their eyes. Perhaps it is because of their proximity to the Dark Elven lands. I see that they did in fact make the stories of this slavery at this point. I mean, they did canonize it, at least. Enemies isn't worth it, it doesn't give me a lot. I heard the priests in the Conclave of Baal in Stormhold know the location of Murkwood, yet hold it a dear secret. I doubt they will tell you the truth unless it's for the right price. I am in Stormhold, right? Yep, so where was it again? I'm sorry, I missed that. I completely missed that. Fenris of the market told my brother that his son overheard two men talking something about a map to Murkwood being in a collapsed prison. Being in a collapsed portion of the Conclave of Baal. Maybe you should ask the Conclave of Baal, is it? Temple. Conclave of Baal. Southeast for a while and ask there. Thank you, you've been a major help. Is this the Conclave of Baal? Well, I doubt it would be this close, but oh well. It is! What? You enter the Conclave of Baal and a cool fall breeze follows you into the hallowed halls. You can hear chanting in the distance. Where are you? Ah, here you are. Aye, my child. I knew the way to find the location. I knew the way to find the location of Murkwood, the dark forest that ever moves. For I am Idolan Lancaster, leader of the Conclave of Baal. Though it was a dire place, it is said that many items were lost within its swamps and bogs. Alas, I fear its secrets will rest forever now. You see, a few nights ago, one of our initiates, thinking to impress his masters, triggered a spell of massive destructive potential. Though the senior brothers tried to dissipate it, they were not able to. The best they could do was channel its power into the very earth itself. Needless to say, the backlash was terrible, collapsing much of the vaults of Gemin. Ah, the site this unfortunate apprentice had chosen to cast his spell. The stone tablet that held the key to the location of Murkwood fell with it. Fell with much of the vault, deep below the earth. I dare say it is lost forever unless... If you would be willing to venture into the collapsed vault and try and recover the tablet, I would be happy to decipher the location of Murkwood and inscribe it onto your map. You would have to return the tablet to me first, however. Will you agree? I guess I don't exactly have a choice, do I? You're doing a great service to the Conclave of Baal. I will not forget it. Well, you could give me something as, you know, repayment. Be careful, however, for we have heard strange noises issuing forth from the dark caverns below. When you have retrieved the tablet, return to this place. I will await you. So I guess that is where we go. I mean, the Vault of Gemins? How do you want to say that? Where is it? Oh, it's right here. Quite close. Based on the current weather, it'll take one day. 80 kilometers. Not too far. Let's go, I guess. Okay, so this is the Vault of Gemins, or I don't know, how would you say that? I wonder. Anyway, let me just go ahead and save you, real quick, so that I don't have to do all that again. And there seems to be nothing here. I've heard that this place is actually quite difficult, and I can hear something snarling already. Oh boy. I think this is just another one of those levels which is gonna require me to have a death counter at hand. Seems pretty linear thus far, but you never know. Mines of Khuras was horrible, man. I mean, it couldn't have been worse, but well, it is what it is, I guess. Oh, sorry, I missed the potion of Heal True, and let me just go ahead and pop in a potion of resist shock. Wait, somebody else is attacking me as well. Who is that? Somebody else is attacking me with a ranged attack. Okay, where did you spawn from? I mean, did you just randomly decide to spawn behind me just to annoy me or something? This calls for a save. Learning my lesson, guys. Learning my lesson from a previous encounter. Hey, this looks like something. I guess those are the signs of destruction that the young apprentice had made. Like, more like, let it be. I was about to say that looks like the signs of destruction that young apprentice left behind, you know, because he unleashed a spell of destruction without knowing how to control it, trying to impress his masters. this. Oh shit. I was right. I am going to need a death counter for this game. For this level at least. Oh boy. Okay, let me just pop in potion of resist fire in advance, because we all know how this thing goes. Nobody here, but there sure is somebody over here. Who threw that fireball at me? Can you show yourself? You coward. This is another one of those rocks. I mean, all these tiny little handpiece details actually bring a lot of life to the place for some reason. There's another door there. I'm probably going the wrong way, but who cares? I mean, that's practically what the game is all about. So yeah, here we go. A table, that is nice. I mean, are these places vaults? I heard something horrible. I like to do that, I don't like for the sounds they produce to be intrusive. I doubt I'm doing any damage. Yeah, right here. Hold up. Alright, fine. That's fine. Yeah, my endurance is still the same, it hasn't increased any. And I don't know what's causing that. I mean, my endurance isn't supposed to be this low. It should at least be in Nebbing Long, so let's just equip that for the time being. We'll use this as a primary weapon until it breaks. In the nick of time. Absolutely in the nick of time. It's curious how I got the guy in the back first, and then the guy in the front. But most curious. Okay, have you explored this place in its totality, if you would like to call it that? Yes, we have. So, I guess this is what we have left to explore here. They're just the randomest of things in the middle of nowhere. Didn't see you there, failed to notice you. And I guess there's another one behind this pillar here, because I did see a ranged attack come from over there, so. Yep, there is another one behind there. Hiding behind the pillars, like a scared little rat. Come forth, so that I may thrust my blade into you. And rid the world of the menace that you are. Hold up! What the actual fuck, man? You know what, I don't even know what that is. Oh, it was a wraith. I swear, sometimes, like, not sometimes, most of the times for this game is just pausing to open your inventory. And nothing more. Nothing more. And yeah, it was sort of a pointless waste of time, this entire thing here, but I guess it was worth checking out for the experience that we gained? I don't know. So should we go here, should we go there? Let me just create another save here. Two of you guys, how lovely. Standing right in front of me, like two little good boys. I think I should just stick to the main corridors instead of going through doors. But then again, I mean, objectives, a lot of times, they do exist beyond locked doors. For example, this locked door might lead me to somewhere I need to go, but I'm not going there, so yeah. Whoa, hold up, like, seriously, what's your problem, man? Can you at least give me a fair fighting chance? I mean, I know I probably wouldn't if I was you, but... You're not me, are you? You're you. You should do the right thing. And not exploit the game like I would. Where are we right now? Something tells me I should probably check the interior of that place first. Let's go back and use the store. I may be completely wrong as well, but... You know. A lot of times being wrong is... A good thing. It isn't, but you know, sometimes you just need to justify your actions with words that do not make any sense. But I wonder how far ago this guy used the destruction spell. Had to adjust my keyboard there for a moment. It's a skeleton. But it's the body of a skeleton. Let me just go ahead and use my Ring of Healing, which I've completely healed again. Do I want to save here? Sure, why not? I mean, it may be a bad slot, but that's why I'm using alternate slots, so... So I've got a door here. I guess I shall be using that then. That is where the flapping sounds were coming from. Yep. It's strange how, you know, like a block, whenever your attack gets blocked or parried, it makes that metal on metal sound. This actually looks like a piece of artistic dirt right here. And this looks like a thumbs up. Wait a minute. Are these all parts of a giant human statue that, you know, was poking his thumb up while pooping or something? It definitely looks like that, and there's nothing here. Huh. Well, I wouldn't exactly call it a waste of time, but it was worth the exploration. Where did you come from? Nice to make your acquaintance, and 50 pieces of gold, thank you very much. Now I really like the fact that I met you. Another one? Yes, I see you. Don't worry. Should I? Yeah, I mostly should save. Okay, so where do I want to go now? Should I take the path on the left? Should I take the path straight? I shall take the path on the left. You know, just for the sake of exploration. Okay. Sometimes the game just glitches out and doesn't do what it's supposed to. There should be another one here. Huh, behind me. How did I miss you? Or did you just spawn behind me all of a sudden? Oh, maybe you followed me. I see. This game does this sometimes. I mean, you're just randomly waiting at a place and, you know, you're just doing nothing, minding your own business. And all of a sudden, if an enemy sees you but does not engage, they'll start tailing you. And anytime that another enemy, you know, just happens to spawn and tries to attack you, these enemies will now surround you, will basically pop up from behind you and start attacking you. That calls for the save. Now, do I want to go inside these chambers here? I mean, I don't exactly have another choice. There is no further way to go. So, I guess I'll check this side out first? I don't know. What the? Okay, so something attacked me and it was basically an insta-kill. It was these guys. Yeah, I'll just go ahead and use the Ring of Healing. Why not? Is there anything here? No, there isn't. I can hear ghosts. Do not be a ranged class. It wasn't. This one is. Huh. I wonder how he missed me. Well, at least I'm glad that he did, but... Sometimes these animals just act funny. I know what for, but... They do. Nothing here. I guess I should just make another save then. I mean, a lot of people believe in no save playthroughs, and I don't really see the point in that. I mean, why lose all the progress that you just made? Especially in a game like this where, you know, not taking damage is out of your own hands for the most part. How does it feel to get hit in the crotch, sir? Does it feel good? I shall take that as a yes, seeing how you broke apart and fell down onto the ground. Nah, I don't need to use anything. I could use a save though. That sounded like a fireball, but I don't know who chucked it at me. Nope, that wasn't a fireball, that was one of these winged bastards. Where is the winged bastard? Is there nothing here? Ah, there really isn't anything there. I guess this was another colossal waste of time. Badumts. No, that wasn't a pun, I just felt like saying badumts. I guess, I suppose this is a comparatively smaller dungeon. I guess we'll explore this side then. Let me just go ahead and enter this part of the dungeon and save here. One of the things that I like about this game is, at least it doesn't just randomly spawn enemies in your face. Am I going the right way? Yes, I am. The door just happens to be on the very other side of... And I believe this is where I came in from? Yeah, I did. So, we shall take the path that goes downwards. Out of nowhere, without any warning, I face another stone golem. Interesting. And this space blocked off, so I guess we only have two paths we can take. Either this one here, or I'm guessing it is a path, because, the walls here are painted onto the map, but this part isn't. And I like how this guy, you know, just paints so fast. This guy just literally... You give him, like, you just need, all you need to do is just pass by some point, and this guy's already painted it in. The battle axe. Yes, I shall drop it. Because it is not enchanted. In this game, only metal armor can be enchanted. Nothing more. And, it seems a bit unfair, but... yeah, I guess that sort of balances things out. Since metal armor is mostly for exclusively... warriors. It's supposed to be an exclusively warrior thing. And, we did a save again in temp, right? Yeah, not empty. And the rest of it can be worn by pretty much anyone, like leather, armor, chain. Wow, that guy killed me. Almost. He would have succeeded, but almost. I think I should pop in another potion of resist fire just to be safe. And this place had nothing. So, out we go. So where do we go next? I mean, there isn't any way to proceed here. So I guess we take this route? Or what we can do is check out this thing here. If it is in fact a corridor, is it? No, we missed it by one. Huh. Interesting. A door just randomly opening and closing by itself, or so it would seem. Horror effects. Oh, finally! Finally! I can now go back to having a higher level of endurance. No? Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. True. Huh. Endurance. Will. Endurance. Will. Endurance. Or will. What do I want? What do I want more? I mean, I don't really need much more luck. Not in this playthrough anyway. So... what do I want more? Endurance? Or willpower? I mean, I could do with more willpower, because endurance gives me health and boost to my health. But willpower, it really helps me out with magic defense, like it keeps me better protected against magic. Melee classes are advised usually. Yeah, look, now it's back to normal now. And I like this. I like this. Heal mod is plus 3. So yeah, I mean, melee classes like mine are usually advised to go increase their magic stats, like willpower, just so that they can defend themselves against ranged magic attacks better. Is this round shield enchanted? It isn't. Then I shall keep it down. And I forgot the last playthrough that I did in fact have a Dwarven Shield of Passwall, which I bought for just that specific purpose in the event that I would like to use it, but... oh well, you forget what you forget, I guess. No better way to put it other than that. And this seems to be like... yeah. Who the... well, I'm glad there's nobody else here. Temp, was it? Yes. My screen turned off suddenly, out of nowhere for some reason, and I didn't really know what to make of it as or what happened, but yeah, anyway, I probably did cut that part out. If I didn't, then, well, you guys got to take a peek at my desktop and all the naughty things that there are over there. This map seems to have a little bit of verticality to it. I guess we shall just proceed on downwards, then. No point in staying here. I don't know if I did save, but I shall save again. I do believe I haven't explored further this way. Grinding noises. Let's check this door then. Because ever since the Mines of Khuras, where did that attack come from? Seriously. I was saying that ever since the Mines of Khuras had its, the entry to the next floor of the dungeon right in, smack dab in the middle of the map, I have been very upset, and I've been basically checking out the middle of the map before I go ahead and check anything else, simply because, you know, it can be somewhere that we have to check out. So yeah, that. Let me just take this opportunity to save here. I do believe I'm not making a mistake by saving at this point. Nothing here. I believe it was already marked, like this part was marked off, wasn't it? I guess I needlessly did check it. Oh my god, what? Ah, I see, it was a lightning attack. And a potion of resist shock, so that I can deal with you guys better. Ring of healing. Man, look at the range on this longsword. I guess that's why they call it a longsword. Poor pun, but I guess they just fucked off to nowhere without an explanation. whoever they were that dared attack me. Why do you guys always peek from behind a corner like it is an FPS like CSGO? Saw your red glinties. Red glinty eyes. I just used it anyway. I mean, I do have a lot of potions of healing. Not that that gives me any valid excuse to waste them. Wow, that was close. That was close. Not that that actually gives me any valid excuse to waste them, but yeah. It's better to use them when your health is low. I mean, that is practically what they were intended to do. They were intended for in the first place, so... Intended. Plate ball drawn, right plate ball drawn, nope. You will not be fetching me any money. Okay, so save game again. This looks like a lovely little room wherein I can progress further. Yeah, I did just save. Whoa, this artistic toad scared me. I thought it just suddenly spawned onto the screen like that, and I didn't expect that. I thought maybe it was a new kind of gruesome sort of an enemy, but it wasn't. It was just an artistic piece of toad. Interesting. Quite interesting. Let me just go ahead and check this part out first. A dead body here. A mark, kite shield, and an iron longsword. Now let me check what I can dispose of. Kite shield, iron longsword, yes. Time to dispose. Time to take care of the waste. Do I want to look up there or do I want to continue downwards? I think I should look up there first. I see you. Fucking wraiths, man. I mean, these guys are relentless. They will kill you the first chance they get. Oh, it's just you. I wonder why they never glint when, you know, why they never glow like that when I'm searching for them. They only do that when I come close to them. Anyway, saving again. I know I don't need to say keep saying saving every time I do save, but look at that. Isn't it wonderful that I did come here? Saving. I just like to inform you guys that I'm saving because I'm saving.